When I first bought the camera, I didn't know that it was going to change my life. Whoops. Since the first moment I clicked open the shutter, it was like my Pandora's box. All the negative feelings inside me came rushing out. I felt upset, discontent, bored with my life. I'm a Singaporean, I have all the 5 C's, the car, the career, the condominium, the cash, the credit card. So, why was it not enough? Why was I not happy? So I needed to know the answers, and I packed my bag, quit my job, took off and traveled the world. I visited the countries of Buddhism, Hinduism, Santeria, traveled across Asia to South America, Cuba, and Mexico, trying to find these answers. So now 5 years later, and 5 C's poorer, I'm back with a different mind, eye, and heart. And today I'm very pleased to present to you the results from the 5 years. It is called Light From Within, my new book. And the answers that have revealed themselves to me. So after this slideshow, I will share with you how I have tried to understand the concepts of human suffering and spirituality intact, and because I believe that the orishas need to be appeased and fed the life and the blood and the heart of the animals, while the santeros themselves eat the meat for nourishment. The blood is supposed to contain the life force of the animal. During a Santeria ritual, so here you can meet the gods of Santeria. On the left, the white one is Obatala, the protector of our head, and Chango, the god of thunder, and Yemaya, the goddess of the sea, and Ochun, the protector of the river. And this is the park, Almendares, in Havana, where all the Santeros go to perform their rituals and make their offerings. So to me, it was like I smelled death in the air everywhere. And that was how I felt at that time of shooting. And then moving on to India, to the Ganges River, where the Hindus go to wash away their sins, purify themselves, and bless themselves. This is an Indian sadhu, a wandering monk, and the Indians, they paint their gods blue, because blue, like the sky, represents transcendental wisdom. So I have a god come to life here. This shot was taken in Kolkata, one of the most crowded and dirty places I've been, but the photo revealed the purifying power of water and light to me. The Kali, goddess of witchcraft, she protects us against evil. And here again, the Indian gods come to life. In Cochin, during the monsoon season, like Mike, I love to shoot in the rain. At a wedding in Jaipur, Rajasthan, my own dreams and ambitions come true. But it has evolved to a stage where I believe now that it's consciousness, courage, and action that we need to fulfill the full fulfill the full human potential. My beliefs have shifted from emphasizing the external to drawing on the internal. And because I believe that life change, it starts from within. Your world changes when your view of the world changes. So if you don't have money and you can't buy things, if you're thinking that, or you could think that it's a state of poverty, or you could see it as, can celebrate the lightness that you enjoy by not having possessions weigh you down. So a universal truth of world religions and great universal philosophies is that the kingdom of heaven lies within you. So I met a Buddhist monk in Chiang Mai, and he told me something very interesting. What our eyes see at the very first instance is color, which is the visible spectrum of light, and absolute truth. Only after we have had time to think about what we saw, and we analyze it, and process it, and feel, that what we see, it becomes conventional truth. When we've had time to apply the norms, conventions, preconceptions, prejudices that control our lives each day, when we've had time to apply these to any given situation, it is no longer absolute, it becomes conventional and relative. So Buddhists believe that it is conventional truth that causes suffering. They say that if we see and accept absolute truth as it is, then, and rather than filtering it through our own judgments and prejudices, we will feel no unhappiness, fear, doubt, sadness, or any negative emotions related to suffering.